Hey YouTubers, Hankster here, and welcome to another action figure review. And once again, we're going into the Nightmare on Elm Street storyline, or more into the 1994 release of Wes Craven's New Nightmare. It's the New Nightmare, Freddy. Now, of course, character was still played by Robert Englund at the time. There's a lot of obvious differences between this version of Freddy and the original version of Freddy that we showed you in the previous video. And, close to the figure here. Not a bad likeness. It comes with, two heads. A removable hat. There's a base you can stand them on. And underneath there's a script. Here's a photo of the promotional poster from the movie. This is a cult classic series 2 from Real Toys. This came out around 2005, about 11 years after the original movie came out. Well, this one. And this is series 2, as I said. And here's some stuff about the figure here. It says, Cult Classics, a brand new series comprised of your favorite heroes and villains from classic horror, sci-fi, and action movies. Each figure is highly detailed and comes complete with movie-accurate accessories and display bases. And, of course, in this particular series, not just you have the New Nightmare, but you have Texas Chainsaw Massacre with Leatherface, Donnie Darko, and Phantasm. And, here's the actual figure description. From the mind of Wes Craven, Freddy's origin and appearance are reimagined. Freddy is revealed to be the embodiment of an ancient evil who has been contained through the stories that were told about him. After the final nightmare, Freddy is able to break free from his character's fictional existence and cross over into reality. It's called New Nightmare Freddy. And, as you can see, it's a little bit more demonic looking than the original Freddy. It's more, skin is melted away, showing more of the muscle. But, pictures and what we can see here can't tell you all of it, so let's get this new Freddy out of the packaging and see what he looks like. Alrighty, we got Freddy out of his packaging here, and pretty much, as it says, comes with a stand with the what's left of a column that you attach to the floor base. There's pegs for this, and one peg for one of Freddy's feet. That's for this one here. There's a script. First, if you remember from the movie, there's a script that was floating around, written by Wes Craven, that kind of guides the movie along. And, not too bad looking for Freddy, I can see, tell you here. Now, let's check out the articulation. his left arm could only move from the, apparently from his shoulder. Oh, wait a minute. There we go. We got some shoulders action here. And his hat fell off. His hat loves to pop off. There. And we got some shoulder action here. And, so we got some there. His right arm can move. Let's take a closer look at his right hand. Now, of course, you remember he originally had a glove. Now, this time, it's more of a skeletal claw appendage. I don't know if that's his actual skeleton there. It's connected to the claws. And, of course, originally it was just four claws on the glove. Now he's added a fifth one on the thumb. So. And, of course, he's wearing a trench coat, a leather trench coat, along with the hat and sweater. And the inside of the coat is still, like the sweater, red and green striped. We can catch that. Now, since there's two heads are better than one. So, let's move this head. Take that head off. And there's the second head. Both heads can fit the hat. And so I just took him off his base there for a little bit. Not much difference with the heads, as I can see. Here's the first head. Like somebody just kicked him in the nuts. The expression on his face, like somebody just kicked him in the nuts. I kind of like this. I kind of like this head better. But, this is, of course, new Nightmare Freddy. And, of course, by the time we get to Freddy vs. Jason, he kind of reverts back to the original version of Freddy. So we don't get to see this Freddy past the new Nightmare movie. But, not a bad figure. I like this kind of this figure here. Good detail. Poseable. He can move his legs around. I think he mostly can move his knees. I'm not totally sure. There's only one place to put a foot into a peg. It's over here. His right foot. But, all in all, pretty good collectible, as I say so myself. My third Freddy in the collection. And, hope you enjoyed this little review. Of course, we had the, last two movies to go through, Freddy vs. Jason, and of course, the, reboot of the Nightmare on Elm Street series, as well. So, stay tuned here for more reviews and whatnot here on the Multiverse. See ya.